Almost 2 centuries ago, a seed of feminism sprouted as women fought for their right to vote. Slowly but surely, the suffragettes began to claim a few successes. In the next few decades, with the spike in employment after the Great Depression, as well as the Equal Pay Act, feminists began to solve some of the most misogynist problems that society was tasked with. Today, 172 years later, statements against feminism are circulating on social media, and the patriarchy is still so pervasive, which means that the need for feminism is far from dead. I pride myself on being a feminist. It's a huge part of my identity. Don't get me wrong. I have no interest in reforming somebody's obtuse understanding of feminism. That's a personal journey. However, I merely want to acknowledge what feminism really is, which has so artfully been stifled by misconceptions. I'm not the only one who's angry, but I choose to voice my rage, politely, in a civilized manner. I won't yell, I won't scream, but I vow to whisper at the top of my lungs for the girls who aren't even granted the privilege of a voice. Okay, let's get into it. There are many misconceptions regarding feminism. The most commonly heard one is that feminism is about demeaning men. Now, while feminism is a very complex movement, in simple words, it's basically the advocacy of female rights and pursuit of gender equality. Nowhere does this include demeaning men. Even today, we live in a very patriarchal society. We simply fight for female rights because the discrimination against women solely based on their gender exists and is deeply entrenched in several societies, families, and education systems. Feminists fight for women so that one day we can live in a world that is liberated by the ironclad institution of gender equality that feminists have been supporting for centuries now. If the argument is that the grounds of feminism is regarding demeaning men, then they're referring to misandry or pseudo-feminism, whose foundations hold stark differences to the core of feminism. Another argument that's often used against feminism is that feminism has the word feminine in it, which makes it gender biased. Yes, feminism does have the word feminine in it. It advocates female rights loud and clear. But that doesn't mean it follows some warped misandrist philosophy and is prejudiced against men. Just because feminism aims to uplift women doesn't mean it disregards men. A little history lesson here. As I mentioned earlier, the concept of feminism was first introduced during the suffragette movement in the US. This movement occurred in the late 19th to the early 20th century, and the aim was to ascertain voting rights for women. Now, at the time, this was an issue endured by women, so at the time, the label of feminism seemed fitting. Even though this name has remained the same over a century later, the ideals and aims of feminism have matured and changed since. Now, to individuals who are suggesting names such as equalism or humanism as suggestions or alternatives for feminism, I ask you, what's the reason? Is it really the need of the hour to change a name that slightly irks you when the movement very definitively characterizes itself as one that views all genders through an egalitarian lens? Last but not the least, feminism causes gender division. Wait, that doesn't sound right. Gender division is the reason that feminism is needed in the first place, to bridge the gap of bias that exists between all genders. As a feminist myself, I have absolutely no animosity towards men because that's the opposite of what the movement stands for. However, I think it is absolutely essential to be cognizant of the current patriarchal hierarchy in the social context. And to reach an equal and equitable state, it is absolutely essential for feminism to grow from strength to strength. I'd like to end with a quote from one of the most iconic feminists of all times, Maya Angelou. Each time a woman stands up for herself, without knowing it, possibly, or without claiming it, she stands up for all women. Thank you.